The world consumes energy in many different forms. There are industries who are very big consumers of energy, and currently we are entirely dependent on fossil energy, and the CO2 emissions that result from that is something the world has come together to address and seeking to completely abate. Now, this will take an alternative.
For 80 years now, we humans have made factories where we can make ammonia. Almost all of that ammonia were made from natural gas because that's the cheapest way to make ammonia. But of course, we create CO2 when we do that. But what we do is something new.
So this project, this plant of ammonia in Indonesia, will produce ammonia that has zero CO2 emission in the processing step. From the nuclear power being produced to the final ammonia coming out, there's absolutely no carbon involved anywhere.
One of the exciting things about this project is that there are two new technologies we bring to market. One of them is thorium molten salt reactors. It's a new technology that hasn't been used before. It allows us to lower the cost of the electricity. And this is because we have designed a new patented reactor core called the onion core that uses thorium and heavy water, which can be mass manufactured on assembly line. The other technology is the SOEC electrolysis from Topsoe.
So the solid oxide electrolysis basically uses electricity to split water into hydrogen and oxygen. The hydrogen is then used to produce ammonia, which is a convenient way of either storing the energy from the hydrogen or actually use it as a fertilizer.
When we think about the water that we drink, the conductivity of this water is between 300 up to 500 microsiemens per centimeter. When we talk about electrolysis, the water that is needed for an electrolyzer is below 0.1 microsiemens per centimeter. This water is needed in order to make the process efficient and also to make sure that the electrolyzer doesn't degrade. In our case, we use the MEP technology to desalinate water.
There are other projects looking at, can we use wind or solar or hydropower, sort of other green energy sources to make ammonia, and of course that is also possible, but the problem is the price point. If the price of green ammonia is twice or three times higher than the price of gray ammonia, then it's unlikely that it will scale or become a big business. And what we are trying to do here is to get the price very close to the price of fossil fuel-based ammonia with nuclear technology or nuclear energy.
We strongly believe in Alfa Laval that we need to work together with other companies in order to reach a better future. And here it's a great combination of stable companies that has been in the market for many years, like Topsoe, Aalborg CSP, also Pupuk, Kaltim, but together with Copenhagen Atomics that brings something completely new to the market, completely innovative.
Copenhagen Atomics has spent almost 10 years developing our thorium molten salt reactors. Topsoe has spent more than 20 years developing these technologies. Alfa Laval has spent maybe 60 years developing very high efficiency heat exchangers and desalination units. So bringing all of that knowledge together is what allows us to make this green transition happen at a cost-efficient way.
In Topsoe, we see collaborations like these as hugely important for the energy transition that we are in front of here. Because for us who are involved on the technology side, we sometimes see even bigger challenges in reconfiguring the way the world collaborates and works together. And this is exactly what we're doing and exploring in this project.
When we think about the future, there are a lot of steps that we must do in order to reach net zero scenario. And one of them is clean molecules. And green ammonia plays a very, very important role. First, to decarbonize, for example, the fertilizers part, but ammonia could also play a big role in the maritime industry for shipping industry.
The shipping industry is looking very much into using ammonia directly as a fuel in their ship engines. So one third of the world's shipping fleet consumes the equivalent of the existing ammonia market today. So should one third of the ships that we have today and sail today switch to ammonia fuel, you would need to double the world's capacity of ammonia production. I believe that a project like this has the potential not only to address a fertilizer issue in a given region, but actually co-produce ammonia for fertilizer, ammonia for energy usage, but also energy just as energy. And with a plant like this, you can actually choose to have all three of those products.